मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस वीडियो यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ग्रीन हाउस एफेक्ट एंड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग सो नाउडेज दिस इज अ वेरी बिग प्रॉब्लम टू एस सो व्हाट इज ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एंड ग्रीन हाउस एफेक्ट. The solar radiation is absorbed by the surface of land and ocean. The heat from sun, the solar radiation in the form of light. So solar radiation is absorbed by the surface of land and ocean. In turn, they release infrared radiation or heat from the sunlight. We will get the infrared radiation or heat into the atmosphere. So certain gas molecule present in the atmosphere absorb the infrared ray or heat and emit it into the earth. So that is called a global warming. The solar radiation is absorbed by the surface of land and ocean. In turn, they release infrared radiation or heat into the atmosphere. So certain gases molecule present in the atmosphere absorb the infrared and emit to the earth. So infrared rays and re-radiated the heat in all direction. Hence these gases maintain the temperature of the earth surface. So the gas which absorb the radiations are called the greenhouse gases. Those gases called greenhouse gases. And the effect is called greenhouse effect. So what are the greenhouse gases? We have carbon dioxide, N2O, methane, CFC, chlorofluorocarbon, CO2, N2O, CH4, CFC, etc. So the increase the level of these gases result in the gradually increase the temperature of earth surface. So those gases increase in atmosphere, the gas level will increases, it maintain or gradually increase the temperature in the earth surface. So this greenhouse effect is caused due to increase in air pollution. So due to the air pollution, the greenhouse effect is caused. So it result the average increases of the temperature of the atmosphere is called global warming. What is meant by global warming? Increase the air pollution and result the average increase of temperature. Average increase of temperature in atmosphere is called global warming. What is the greenhouse effect? These gases maintain the temperature of earth surface. These gases which absorb these radiations are called greenhouse gas effect. So this is very important question, students. Define global warming. Define greenhouse effect. So what are the greenhouse gases? We have carbon dioxide and an N2O, CH4, CFC. What is meant by CFC? Chlorofluorocarbon. So effects of global warming. So what are the effects? First one is melting of ice caps and glacier. So due to the melting of ice caps and glacier, increase the level of sea. or ocean. Due to increase the atmospheric temperature, the melting of ice cap and the glaciers, so increasing the level of ocean and the sea. So second one is increase in the frequency of floods, soil erosion, unseasonal rain. Due to the global warming, increase in the frequency of floods. Due to increase the global warming, increase in frequency of floods, soil erosion, unseasonal reason. Then third one is loss of biodiversity due to the extinction of coral reefs and other key species. Loss of biodiversity due to the extinction of coral reefs and other key species. Next one is spreading of waterborne and insect-borne diseases. Spreading of waterborne and insect-borne diseases. This is very, very important question, students. So, effect of global warming. What are the effect of global warming? Melting of ice cap and glacier, increase in the frequency of floods, soil erosion, and the unseasonal rain. Next one is loss of biodiversity due to the extinction of coral reefs and other key species, spreading of waterborne and insect-borne diseases. So next one is preventive measures. So what are the preventive measures we have to take to reduce the global warming and the greenhouse effect? So in order to serve the earth and its resource, we need to take certain measures. So some of the measures are given below. So what are the important preventive measures? First one is reducing in the use of fossil fuel. Due to use of the fossil fuel, it produces greenhouse gases, that is carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide. So we have to reduce the using in fossil fuel. Fossil fuel is used as a vehicle fuel. So from the fossil fuel they produce petrol, diesel, kerosene. So it has a multi-utility. So reducing the use of fossil fuel. Second one is controlling deforestation. So cutting of trees, we have to control the cutting of trees. So controlling deforestation. Next one is restricting the use of CFC, chlorofluorocarbon is very dangerous gas for ozone depletion. This gas will affect the ozone layer. It will make the hole on ozone layer. So ultraviolet rays is directly penetrate to the surface, earth surface. So we have to restrict the use of chlorofluorocarbon. Chlorofluorocarbon used as a refrigerant in air conditioning or refrigerator. So next one is planting more trees. That is called afforestation, planting of more trees. So if we plant more tree means the atmospheric carbon dioxide is consumed by that trees in photosynthesis, and it gives more oxygen in photosynthesis. So consumption of carbon dioxide and giving oxygen gas into the atmosphere. So next one is reducing, reusing and recycling resources. So reducing, reusing and recycling resources we have to implement. So then only we have to reduce the pollution. So next one is using renewable energy sources. What are the renewable energy sources? Solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy. These are the renewable energy. We have to use the alternate renewable energies. So once again, what are the preventive measures? Reducing in the use of fossil fuel, controlling deforestation, planting more tree, restricting the use of chlorofluorocarbon, reducing, reusing and recycling sources, and using renewable energy sources. So next one is the acid rain. So what is acid rain? The rainwater is the purest form of water. Rainwater is the purest form of water. However, the pollutant such as, what are the pollutant? Sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, nitric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. So oxides of nitrogen and sulfur in the air released by factories. So factory release nitrogen dioxide and nitric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. These are mixed with water vapor in cloud. So not only release the factories, the burning of fossil fuel, eruption of volcanoes. So from this, the oxides of nitrogen sulfur is released. So dissolved in rainwater and form a nitric acid and sulfuric acid. They may dissolved in rainwater. The oxides of nitrogen and sulfur dissolved in rainwater, they formed as a sulfuric acid and a nitric acid, which add up to the acidity of the rainwater. So hence it result in the acid rain. So this is called acid. What is acid rain? Dissolved rainwater and form the oxides of nitrogen and sulfur dissolved in rainwater, they form nitric acid and sulfuric acid. So this is called acid rain. Acidity of rainwater is called acid rain. So from the diagram you have to observe that. So industries produce NO2, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide. So this is directly mixed with the cloud and producing the nitric acid and sulfuric acid. So it spoil the, it kill the plants and living things. So trees killed by acid rain and damage the building also. So acid rain has the pH. What is the rainwater pH? 7. Okay. If the acid rain means the pH is 5.6, whereas the pH of pure water is around. Five to six due to the dissolution of atmospheric carbon dioxide in it. So acid rain pH is less than 5.6. So below 5.6 it become acidic, more acidic in nature. So normally the pure water the pH is 7. But the dissolution of carbon dioxide dissolved with the water, rainwater, the pH is around 5.6. So then, preventive measures. So what are the preventive measures of acid rain? So acid rain, its effect can be controlled by the following ways. So minimizing the usage of fossil fuels such as petrol, diesel. We have to use the alternate. So electric car or any other fuels, biodiesel, etc. Using CNG, what is by CNG? Compressed natural gas is an alternative source. CNG is an alternative source, compressed natural gas. And using non-conventional source of the energy. Using non-conventional source of energy. The last one is proper disposal of industrial waste. Proper disposal of industrial waste. So these are the preventing measures. So minimizing the usage of fossil fuels such as petrol, diesel, using CNG gas. What is my CNG? Compressed natural gas. So using non-conventional source of energy and a proper disposal of industrial waste. So that's all about this lesson, your lesson. So you have completed the full lesson. Thank you, students.